Good morning students, welcome to the English class. I am Dr. Tripti Gupta from Shivjyoti Education Group Kota. We are going to take up the revision for our poem 2 of our first flight book, that is Fire and Ice, written by Robert Frost. So students, let us move to our poem Fire and Ice. So students, our poem Fire and Ice, we will take up the summary here of this poem. The poem starts with the words spoken by the people in and around him, around the poet. Okay, he says that a few people agree with the fact that the end of the world would be in fire. Now, a few others, they are having a contradicting thought that the fact by saying that the world would end in ice. Now here, this is the poet says here that from his personal experiences, he says that the fire and ice, they are the symbols of, basically this is a very symbolic poem here. The fire is the symbol and of human desires. Okay, there are the symbols of two different sides of the human animal, the passionate and the rational. Okay, one aspect is that he has been very passionate, very desirous, and he has lots of desires, and the way he has been passionate about something, that is the fire aspect. And the another aspect is being rational. He's been having lots of prejudices, and those prejudices, those cold hearted feelings which he has been having is basically the ice. So he is, the poet has been talking about the end of the world, how it will actually happen, because what will be the reason for the world to come to its end. So here, our passion defines our animal nature, while our reason makes us humans. So he too agrees to the possibility of the world, of the end of the world with fire. Okay, so the poet is upset if the world ends twice. So he cannot assume that it cannot actually happen that the world would end twice. So it is not actually, he is aware that the world is filled with hatred and enmity. So there is lots of jealousy, lots of hate, okay, and it is filled with enmity. People are being feeling they feel that they are being enemy to another person, okay, and that will lead to the destruction of the world someday or the other. Okay, he admits that ice can also be equally destructive like fire. So he gives this justification that the hatred, the jealousy, the enmity which is possessed by human beings for one another is, can also be another strong reason for this world to come to an end. He concludes by saying that for the world to be ended, fire and ice are equally sufficient. So both have equal, they both are being enough competent to end the complete world. So here, so students, now let us discuss the theme of this poem. Fire and Ice deals with the question, whether the earth would be destroyed in fire, that is the desires of the man, or in the global warming, or will it be in a blast of ice, that is the symbol of hatred, jealousy and enmity, okay, like a nuclear winter or the exhaustion of the earth's molten core. So this is the physical phenomena also which can lead to the end of the world. So this short poem outlines the familiar question about the fate of the world, how the world is going to end, wondering if it is more likely to be destroyed by fire or by eyes. So fire also here, like as we can see here in the theme, the fire describes the war, and ice describes the cold winter, the chilly icy phase which the earth can move in, and finally it can be destroyed. The poem is a textbook example of extended symbolism. Hot and cold are the symbols that we use every day. So that is how this poem is all about. So students, I hope you will be able to understand this poem well, prepare it well. Thank you, students.